Hello students, today I am starting with a new chapter in EVS 1, which is Rules are for Everyone. Kindly remove your textbook, page number 28. Thank you. Rules are for everyone. Students, can you tell me some traffic rules? Can you tell me what are the different type of traffic rules? See, we follow traffic rules so that traffic moves smoothly. No, if there are four roads and if the vehicles are coming from all the directions, then there will be jam and there will be accident. No, the roads will get crowded and lots of traffic. So there are signals on the road, if you have seen, no? So if there is red light, so stop, it means stop. Green light means go, and yellow light means wait, get ready, you're going to be next. So there are different traffic rules, right children? So similarly, if there are rules for everyone, and rules indirectly or directly helps a person to become disciplined and understand that what is right and what is wrong. Give reason why we should obey these rules. As I told you, no? Why we should obey? If you don't follow rules, then you will not learn, no, what is correct for the situation. So what is correct for the situation? No, everywhere there is a rule. If you are coming to school, there is a rule that you should be reaching school by 12:20 or 12:25. If you are late, then teacher gives you late remark. No, so why are rules important? Because rules bring discipline in your life. No, everywhere there is a rule. Okay, in your house also there are certain rules. So we will learn one by one. Okay, rules are social life that tells us what each person should be doing. No, rules tell us what to do and what not to do. Made to specify each person's duty and responsibility. Right, children? Our day-to-day life becomes disciplined and we work efficiently. What is the meaning of efficient? Means we work in a very organized manner. No, if you have school tomorrow, so what you will do? You should do timetable according to your daily timetable, whatever is given from school. No, Monday, Tuesday, every day there are different timetables we follow. So you should set your timetable according to one day prior. If tomorrow is Monday, so we have to set the timetable according to it, not just before going to school. We should set it one day before only. Okay, Sunday only you should keep your bag packed and you should set your timetable. You should check your compass box whether you have two pencils, one eraser, scale and Fevicol. You have kept all your things or not. Right, children? So if there are rules, it helps you to bring discipline in your life. Disobeying leads to punishment. If you are late for school, if you don't cut your nails, no, if your father is late for his office, so obviously there are punishment in the sense will give late remark in your calendar or will cut half day salary. So every school, every office, every place, every mall, shopping malls also have their rule. You can't keep open after 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock at night. You know, there are rules and these rules are set by the institute or government or in your house also. For example, small children should have their food by dinner by 8:30 or 9 o'clock and go to sleep by 9:30, because they have to get up early in the morning, no? So this rule is set by your grandfather or grandmother or by your mother, who says finish your food and go to sleep. Sleep by 9:30, or Saturday, Sunday you can sleep by 10, 10:30. So there are rules, no? Then you should, before eating food, you should wash your hands and do things properly. So this all things also comes in rule. These are rules, okay? Disobeying leads to punishment. If you don't follow rules, you will get punishment. And no discrimination in punishment, okay? Whether it's a girl, it's a boy, or it is a teacher's son, or it is a manager's child, or whoever it is, it doesn't matter. If the rules are for everyone, everyone should follow the rules. See, if you're eating a pan and you're spitting on the road, whether you're a minister or you're a doctor or you're a cobbler or you're a rickshawala, anybody, punishment is for everyone because it is wrong. You should not break rules. If you're breaking rules, you will get punishment. Okay, children, equality is the basic rule. Okay, changes in rules for the society. There is a difference between rules of society and laws of nature. Okay, natural occurrence follow laws of nature. We cannot change the laws of nature. Things which are natural, it is not in your hand. Okay, children, like if it is raining today, you can't say stop raining, no, because it is a natural, something which is natural. It is not in our power. We don't have any power, or we don't have any stop button that please stop raining. You can't stop rains, or you can't stop earthquake, you can't stop floods, no, children. So natural nature, law of nature, which are related to environment, you can't change, no, children. But rules of societies can be changed, because rules are man-made, no? Rules are man-made. The rising and setting of the sun, see? Can you say, sun, please don't rise today, I don't want day only, I want to sleep whole night, I don't want sunlight. Can you do that? Change in season never stop. See, as June, July, August, September, these 4 months are rainy season. You can't change it. You can't say September or August there will be summer season. That is nature. You can't change nature. The law of gravity does not change. What is gravity, children? Whatever you throw upwards, it always comes down because of the gravitational force of the earth, the pull of the earth, right? So you can't change it. The rising and the falling of tides, the phases of the moon, all of these things occur according to the laws of nature. Aaj full moon hai, kal new moon hoga, aisa nahi hai. Partially change hoga na, sab, it will change one by one. It won't change directly. There are steps and there are period for it. Okay? New moon to full moon, it is 15 days. Right, children? So, this all are nature, natural things which we can't change. So, keep in your mind, things which, laws of nature, you can't change, could not be changed. Okay? But nature's law are constant, fixed, and never outdated. Okay, they are never outdated. Human laws need to be changed with changing condition. My grandfather was a farmer who was using 2 bulls for farming. But my father is a farmer, he can buy a tractor, no? He can use modern methods. Because with time things change. So human laws, human nature can change, but you can't change nature and environment, okay? The laws followed in India under the rule of British were different, right? When Britishers were there, that time different rules were there, okay? Different laws were there. For example, after independence, the voting age was 21 years. After 1988, the voting age was lowered to 18 years, okay? Previously, 19, you can vote at the age of 21 only. But in 1988, the new law came, new rule was brought that a person who is 18 years can start voting. So that is, you have made changes, you know, in the society. Like, previously girls can't study, girls can't go to school, right, children? But nowadays, girls need to study, they have equal rights. So human laws keep on changing. See, gender discrimination. What is gender discrimination? As I told you, previously, only boys can go to school. Boys can enjoy the fruit of education. Boys can go out to work. And girls were like, do cooking, washing clothes, sweeping the floor, raising the children. So, all household work. My mother is a housewife. That's what we used to. But nowadays, things have changed. With men, even the women have started working, started earning. See, now we ladies also have equal rights, and we are also educated, and there are lots and lots of successful women all around the world, okay? So boys and girls, always remember, boys and girls or men and women are equal. They must get the same opportunity for development. People of every age need nourishing food. Boy should eat 5 chapati and the girl should eat 2 chapati. Because the boy is going out to work and he will bring money. So he should be healthy and he should be strong. And the girl should not get enough food. It's okay because she is staying at home, which is absolutely wrong. Boy or girl, both are equal. They should get equal nourishing nutritional food, okay? If the boy eats 4 chapati and if the girl wants to eat 4 chapati, she can eat. It doesn't mean that she will not eat, okay? She will eat less. If she wants to eat more, she should be fed more. She should be given more to eat. Because it's her right, you know, it's right to equality. Don't girls need as nourishing a diet as is given to boys? At home, they feel only my brother needs good food. Which is wrong, children. See, even whether it is your grandmother, whether it is your mother, whether it is your sister, all required nourishing foods. The ladies in the house does lots of physical work. It is not easy that she doesn't require good food. She requires good amount of food. She requires nutrition. But then only she can, if she is healthy and hearty, she can run the family. She looks after you all people. No? Whether she works at home or she goes out to work, she has equal rights to get her nutritional values. Okay? Incorrect to discriminate between boys and girls. It is unjust to deprive girls of good food or prevent them from going to school. I hope with this simple chapters you will understand, and there will be lots and lots of positive changes in our society. Observe. What injustice do you observe? I have returned all your money. How can I still be in debt? Okay. Even though I work without a single holiday in the month, why do you pay me so little? See how we do injustice, children. This is a poor farmer or a worker who must have returned all the money, whatever money he must have taken for his farming, or must have taken whatever loan he must have taken from this zamindar or the thekedar or whatever you call it. There are different names: zamindar, thekedar, contractor, munimji, whatever. So see, this poor fellow, he is not educated, no? So he's showing, see, तुम्हारा अभी भी ये ये पैसा बाकी है, तुमने भरा नहीं है. What he is saying, I have returned all your money. How can I still be in debt? मैंने तो सारे पैसे भर दिए, अभी भी कैसे मैं उधारी मेरा बाकी है, आप बताओ. That's what he is trying to say. And here in the second picture, the lady who works in your house, she is not your servant, she is providing you service. वो आपको help कर रही है, हाँ. Full month she doesn't take holiday, but we cut their money and we don't pay them, or we pay very little money, which is wrong. Because of this workers, you are having a flexible life. No children. So maids ho ya house help ho, you should also understand their problems. If she is not keeping well, or if she has any issues, then you should always try and support them, right? You should not cheat them. And this first picture, the man is not educated, it doesn't mean that you will cheat. No, if he has paid you, why you want to tell that no, you have not yet paid me, which things are wrong. A list of rule is given below. Each rule has a specific purpose. Some rules have more than one purpose. Discuss each rule in class under the heading, this is what I think. Note down your opinion. So let us discuss. Prohibition against loudspeaker in public place after 10 o'clock at night. This should be allowed or it should be not allowed? After 10 a.m. you should allow loudspeakers. No. It causes noise pollution. It affects, no? Which is not. There should be a strict rule that no disco, no party, no loudspeaker after 10 o'clock. Free primary education for boys and girls. Yes, I think free education should be given, no? To boys and girls. So, padega India to badega India. So, it is very important. Prohibition against dumping garbage in the river. You should not allow garbage in the river, no? We use river water for drinking, right? Rivers and lakes have inland water, which is drinking water, and you should sweet water, which we use for drinking. So we should not allow garbage dumping, no? So prohibition is important. Protection against domestic violence for women. Yes, if the man hits the woman in the house, which is wrong. The woman is not any man's property, okay? So you can't hit any woman. Ban of child labor. You must have seen small children on the road or on the railway station selling mobile pouches and selling small small plastic toys and all, no, small children. So after 14 years you can work, but below 14 years it is a child labor, okay, you can't work. So ban on child labor, ban on felling trees, hunting and poaching. See, you can't cut trees, you can't hunt, you can't kill a tiger or any animal. So these are the few things which I think it is very important. We follow customs and tradition by observing our parents, grandparents and other relatives. We celebrate festival, welcome guests and hospitable them. See, if my father celebrates or does Ganesh Puja at every year, even I will follow that custom. If you see your mother's every morning she does puja and then she starts her daily work, then even we learn from it, no? So this all things we learn from our parents, grandparents and relatives. We express love and gratitude towards animals. We should don't hurt anybody. The values of non-violence and peace has been part of our social life since ancient time. Okay, our Indian society has lots and lots of values, good values. Nowadays, what is the good value in COVID? Don't shake hands, join your hands and do namaste. So that is also a good value. And India is a non-violent country. We are peace-loving country. No, we should not fight among us or with anybody. Some customs like untouchability and caste distinction are not desirable and has given rise to inequality. Okay, there is nothing untouchability, you know. If you cut my finger also, you will get red blood. And if you cut any Brahmin also, you will get red color blood only. Okay, so it is not that this person is untouchable or all these things, no. This were 100 years back. Now we are modern India, so we should not think of all this thing. We should be happy and we should stay together and there should be equality. The Constitution of India abolishes the custom of untouchability. There is no one as no one is untouchable. Think we are all equal. It is very important, children. Don't take advantage of your caste, creed. No, everyone is equal. The law has banned. What all things have banned? Let us see in our country. Injustice like sati, child marriage, receiving dowry has been banned by law. You know what is sati, children? In 100 years back, Raja Ram Mohan Roy and lots of other social reformers worked very hard to abolish or sati practice. You know, means if the man dies, the wife, okay, if the husband dies, the wife will also sit on the chita and then they put it on fire. Means the man is already dead, but the woman is alive. So they used to put her to burn. And that is sati, means she has got what you say, mukti, and she has, I don't know, matlab, I'm not getting that word. She has become what? She has got moksha and she has fulfilled her duties of a good wife, getting herself burnt alive, which was wrong, children. Child marriage, 6 years girl, 8 years boy got married. What? They don't know also that person. They don't know what is marriage and they are married. No? Then receiving dowry. My son is an engineer, so give me 10 lakhs. If you want your daughter to get married to my son, you have to give 10 lakhs. My son is a doctor, you have to give 50 lakhs. If you want your daughter to get married to my son. So that is dowry. We want 1 kg sona. 1 kg. So this all are dowry. You know, receiving dowry is, all these things has been banned. Sati is totally banned. Still there are child marriages in remote states of remote villages of India. You can say there are few places. There is still dowry, which is banned by law. But there are people who take dowry, which is wrong. Don't take money from in the name of marriage, you know, which is wrong. The law that has banned the use of magic for cheating people was first enacted in Maharashtra. Okay, if you are cheating anybody, मैंने ये स्कीम निकाला है, इसमें आप इतना पैसा दोगे ना, 50,000 दोगे तो आपको 1 lakh मिलेगा. See that, this is all chit fund. How can a person give you, if you are giving him 50,000 and that person will in 1 year or in 3 years, you will get double of it. It is not possible. All that things are cheating. You are cheating people. See, work hard and get whatever you want. There is no shortcut. No shortcut in life. Okay? For studies, for work, for anything. Wrong custom and tradition cause the neglect of some section of society. They have no access to education. Therefore, they don't get opportunities of development. Right, children? They have no means of livelihood. See, work hard, study and achieve. If you are educated, you can become a successful person. See, the first thing is education. Second is hard work. Okay? Therefore, they have to face poverty. If you don't study, so you will think of doing shortcut. How I will earn money now? Let's do some cheating business. Poverty and lack of education are the two big obstacles in our society. We can only make progress together if we get rid of these obstacles. Protection of our environment. Just as laws are necessary to maintain equality and justice in society, laws are also required for the protection of environment. We are dependent on nature in many ways. Most of our needs are fulfilled by nature. Natural resources should be available in enough quantities for the needs of our future generation. Therefore, we must conserve these natural resources. We must use them carefully. Are we using them carefully? No, children. We are cutting trees, making construction, and I call it destruction. Everywhere there is destruction. Construction and destruction, both are going hand in hand. So many trees we are cutting every day. So obviously there are lots of pollution. There are laws, children, but who is following that law? I don't know. Mother Earth is crying because the environment is totally destructed. And we should use natural resources carefully. We should save water, we should save petrol, we should save environment, we should save mineral, soil, land, everything. I don't know how much is saved, but we are trying our level best to bring awareness in our society. Because we humans are dependent on nature. See, if there is no trees, very less trees, how we will get oxygen? How the roots will be intact? The land फ्रॉम वेयर वी विल गेट फ्रूट्स वेजिटेबल्स इफ एवरी लैंड इज डिस्ट्रक्टेड एंड मेड इन मेड अ बिग बिल्डिंग एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन इज टेकिंग प्लेस. हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सेव मदर अर्थ? सी, ट्रीज आर वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट. प्लांट मोर एंड मोर ट्रीज. कंजर्वेशन ऑफ नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस, एनर्जी, सॉइल, लैंड एंड रिसाइकलिंग इट. सी, वी हैव टू यूज थिंग्स विच वी कैन रिसाइकल. लास्ट 30 to 40 years प्लास्टिक हैज डिस्ट्रॉयड अवर एनवायरमेंट. ओके, नाउ लास्ट 5 years वी आर ट्राइंग टू ब्रिंग अवेयरनेस. सो लेट्स ट्राई एंड ब्रिंग डिफरेंस इन अवर सोसाइटी. Okay, things to remember. Do you know caste discrimination, gender inequality and lack of education for women were some of the big obstacles in our society? Mahatma Jyotirao Phule, Rajashri Sahu Maharaj, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar tried to get rid of these obstacles. Savitribai Phule, you know, she was the wife of Mahatma Jyotirao Phule, had to fight a great battle for women's education. Her colleagues Fatima Sheikh provided her with valuable assistance in this fight. Maharishi Dhundu Keshav Karve also did great work to promote women's education. See, there are lots and lots of leaders who have really worked hard. Much harder than we are thinking. Now we are getting everything easily and we can just say, but these people have really worked hard to bring changes in society, to uplift the women rights, you know, because women were very ill-treated in before independence and after independence also. I think last 25 to 30 years there has been lots and lots of changes. In 70s and 80s also there were lots of injustice on women. I think modern India has evolved after 2000. So last 25 to 30 years lots and lots of women have got their rights and they have come out and they are educated. The work of all these social workers was instrumental in bringing about positive change in our society. What we have learned, rules made, what we have learned in this chapter, children, rules made for people are changed from time to time. Okay, rules made by human can be changed for the betterment of the society. Okay, rules in the golden days were in the form of religious tradition and social custom. Laws are made to combat human inhuman and undesirable tradition and custom. So few things, see, things which are laws of nature you can't change. You can't change things which are made by nature, you know. And laws made by human can be changed for the betterment of society, okay? For better education, for better living, for better environment, we can always bring changes in our society. And see, rules are important to bring discipline in your house, in your society, in your school, in the country. So there are rules to bring discipline and work efficiently. Efficiently means to work smoothly in an organized manner. Kindly write down this dictation words. Thank you.